and ultimately created a system of machines in bland white attire that he was mad with creation the first 2 weeks of his return, while I stayed with society to make sure that things continued to run smoothly. He was obsessed with everything that could be utilized from his logic. After Renlin returned from the journey, he returned enlightened by the acceptance of pure logic being the means by which we utilize our environment. Renlin ultimately created a system of machine-like soldiers in blind white attire that ran the food churning machines. The matters by which to sustain life in society. Everything became, as they became more dependent on technology, everything became uncontrollably automated. I can't shut this thing off! So come to a computer. Use your extrasensory perception. Oh, that's right. That has grown dormant in all this technological advancement. But not near technology. I am just dependent on the physical. Your logic is your limits. Preconceived dispositions. This old, age-old toys of technology you've built yourselves, creature comforts, turn against you. Mark my words. Rely, put all those eggs in one basket, rely on technology for everything. Computers will become your downfall.
They acted like a real assembly, line production, and a peripheral building inhabit distance out in the middle of such a plain, vast desert, working efficiently in conjunction with each other. Renlin created this circular formation, monotonous food churning process.
What are our news? The scenery is so fluid, blue, liquidy, so thick.
For much creativity, drawings on shoes to feel complexity, ride my old friends to stick out familiarly, the strange faces see, writing new poetry and philosophy. I am on a branch with many other leaves. I am a comet burning free, Italy, burning energy, a bubbling speed, boiling juice flowed out of me. A feeling not had since childhood memory, all due to broadening perceptions of me. Move forward in whatever environment this is. You're coming off a strange, windy, more solid, though. Look at those. Oh my gosh, what is that? I see it's an expanding diagonal lines continuing to a point of perspective. All neon green and blue around me is twinkling. Continue to find out what I see as I go further, it's expanding. Oh, there must be a purpose. I feel I am expanding now. I feel with this great, humongous, powerful, Sorry, I'm expanding at the point of infinity. Must have landed. I'm here. I'm back. I've made it.
I'm infinite.
A twist of wind stood me receiving the diagonal slant of a church palace. The building leaned to me as it seemed to say superiority. An eerie sense of greeting amongst smiling societies welcomed me as if I was pure. The chatter of trivialities brought me to a more comforting normality, until anger from within riled me to discontinue. In their eyes, I was to be given a purpose. A purpose which in itself was not a purpose, but to float in the midst of surface conversation without a partner.
Well,
why must it seem to a niche that one without an immediate purpose needs one? Yet to talk about trivialities was their offered purpose. It was meaningless for me. It was not my purpose. I was looking for something else, and in the shallowness of their reality, all they could see was their being inflicted upon me. Be one of us was uttered through the scene, which became a repulsive feeling. Clones of normality offering the same things, of saying, this is how it is supposed to be, so be an orderly machine. I'm not saying I would rather be anti-productive, but their environment was certainly not one of extensive productivity. The sense of belonging was their flowing energy, but it was that of trivialities that didn't suit me.
Well, you're certainly right, O'Maron.
And you're back! So nice to see you. Thank goodness you're back from the journey.
Yes, I'm back in society. How have things been here?
Oh, they've been fine. I've been working with them to build a better environment. You know, Rendlin has come back with all his ideas, and now we've got the food churning machines working just as good as ever. But you're on the right path, O'Maron. I assume you've become infinite?
Yes, it was a long journey down this diagonal perspective, expanding tiny little point of energy.
Yes, whatever form it takes, it's, that is insignificant. But what the purpose is for you to find yourself, you see. But, what I've come to learn in working with society is, you see, when society becomes established, it constantly spawns normality. I guess this is subconsciously to control chaos and to establish order, but on a large scale, citizens of normality become trivial machines and consisting of none other than being. Maybe it is from will to want to be different or to break the trend of normality that creativity arises. Not being a part of total mass production, you are left with the self from which your personal definition of normality comes. Normality on the external can only be established by and in the physical environment from which it is judged. And judgment can be a very close-minded thing. That's why creativity tends to expand on the external, O'Maron.
Oh, yes, very interesting, I see. Please go on.
But to the individual, on the internal level, normality may not exist. Familiar physical surroundings and conditions constantly exist in reality until they are displaced by life, and that is the only place from which we can truly get the word normal. So normal is a product of the externally physical, the place by which reactions of a collaboration of life takes place in. On the inside level, though, normality cannot be established because there is nothing constant to compare it with. Just like on the outside environment, you see.
Yes, please go on.
Unlike the external, the internal self is constantly changing to adapt to the external. Isn't that ironic? The internal self will never be a constant normality. It will always be contradictory changing to its external environment, which it assumes is normality. So, even on a singular level, a person is drawn to conformity, some way or another. It is when the external reality can be temporarily avoided to look inside the internal that creativity and true feelings can arise. Thus, truth of the individual is obtained by avoiding normality.
Yes, I see. Very interesting, journeyman. Shall we return back to society?
Why, yes, if you like. Whereas we've been working hard and we've established some groups. I always hate to classify because that sometimes, what's the word I'm looking for?
Discriminates.
Yes, discriminates against other individuals, but, see, that's constantly, it's so strange how that can never be avoided. It's normal human reaction to classify things in order to understand them. But people have established identities for themselves, and that's due to the classifications. They're mostly on their part, not mine. Those over there are the artisans. And they are provided housing and food distribution. freely as long as they continue to create their art for all to see. And look off way into the distance, and you can see Renlin's food machines that continue to churn the wheel for the food that we get, and also they also manufacture products for housing.
Yes, how do we get food here on this planet?
Well, there's a natural ore called dilithium cranium that is dug up from the ground. It's very, very plentiful, and it, as it is broken down, provides numerous amounts of nutrients that is almost continuing in an infinite supply, and not to mention how much we have of the ore. Renlin is now still figuring out a way in which to reuse it. So that is becoming less and less of a problem. And people are wanting and seeking more and more governmental positions.
Governmental positions? Or aren't we handling that? The philosophers, the council of philosophers you appointed.
Yes, yes. Yes, we are handling that, Omeron. But as more matters come at hand, we're more positions to lead and understand. So at people's free will, they just decided to lead and head the mining operations for the ore, for example, and there have become needs here and there for repairing of Renlin's food-churning robots, machines that can be easily reprogrammed or what have you, the matter at hand. So there are many things coming to be. And in exchange, shelter is given. And seemingly enough, as in a growing rate, we will have permanent lodging for fixed groups of people, and we will not have to rebuild. So that is very substantial. And
well, once that happens, no one's going to have to want anything to do, and there won't be any help.
Oh, on the contrary, my friend, people are enjoying their work for something to do, just getting out and helping with Renlin's repairs, all the mining operations. You know, many people have expressed a strong interest, hence the word strong, symbolizing how what state of mind the person needs to be in for that operation. They've become interested in working on that group of officers for the minings. And so I've appointed many other people.
Oh, but you're still keeping us, aren't you?
Yes, we're still keeping the Council of Philosophers. You are very useful. In fact, I've got some ideas. I want you to write down what you've learned in your journeys. And
write down?
Yes. Plus, Renlin's returned. He's done that for me. He's also written down a lot of scientific information for us to keep and others to use if they want, as they continue to want to expand those ideas. But, yes, write down any philosophical information.
Oh, well, that should be fine, and what should I use?
Well, only materials that shall last on this environment. You see, I have found byproducts of tools that may come about could easily diminish within the environment, so it is best when creating something to use something of the earth, so it will go back into the earth without destruction.
Yes, I see. So maybe stone?
Yes, stone is very plentiful. Carve the language out into stone. Yes, you must learn the language, that's right. There are so many things going on. People want to learn more and more. I'm just about the only informant here. Renlin is starting up schools too and teaching many people about the sciences and things. But as more and more people learn, more and more people want to do. So once the written language becomes well enough known, then we will have many, many stones, so to speak.
Yes, yes. Well, I'll begin right away, journeyman, and thanks for the advice. My perception has broadened greatly.
Yes, I'm sure it has. I hope it continues to broaden.
Oh, journeyman?
Yes, Omeron?
Has Brutinus returned yet?
No, you and Renlin are the only ones who have returned from the journey.
Oh, well, let me know when gets back.
Go see Redlin to find out where to put and start your writings. He should be up on the top of those two mountain crests over there in the midst of the few small dwindling buildings around the bushes that are blowing in the breeze.
Goodbye.
See you later. This is really a great society I have here. Everyone works at their free will, compelled by non-productivity, as it should be, or non-productivity only.
Everything is infinite.
Bruticus, you're back! Alright. Yeah, did you have a nice journey, Bruticus?
Yes, I did. Very revealing journey. For not only myself, but everyone else here.
Come, tell us. Tell me about it. It's curious. I mean, you've been gone so long, the longest of them all.
Yes, it was a long journey, but seeing the time, I seem to sense was insignificant compared to length. I
come away from the crowd here. Come over here by the water spring.
Well, I did learn many things by standards.
Standards are confinements. Can be confinements on society.
Yes, but not all the time. I mean, look at it this way. The person who is constantly uneasy and asking questions all the time doesn't realize that everyone else wants comfort, rest, love, and self-fulfillment. Therefore, will always be there. The person who figures nothing good can come out of life sits idly by and watches. He who feels he should be depressed or angry at the journey soon will realize that nothing even has a chance of coming out of his journey until he starts. The person who feels that there's everything to go for and runs too quickly will tire out before he finds much. The person who plans life out as a schedule and wants to experience it all his own way will soon become bitter and angry to find destiny in its hands and not his own. Yeah, I know they're classifications, gentlemen, but just listen to me. They're examples, okay? I'll get to the standards point here in a minute. The person who wants to experience everything fun and playfully will eventually lose consideration for himself and others. He will become destructive. He may find his destiny in front of his face without being able to deal with it. And this could be a problem for others. Yes, I agree. But the person who takes life in stride and hopefully anticipates the next hill becomes optimistic and ready for anything. All right, I agree. Oh, by the way, I've told everyone I'd let them know when you get back. Omeron needs Rendlin. They've just been wondering, worried, you know, curious as to what's been going on your journey. I mean, it's so Bruticus. So that they're probably interested in seeing you again, I'll make this point. Okay, so there are all these different kinds of people, my examples. Yes, I agree. I mean, so many different perceptions. Right, and they and they act on them, right? I mean, there's the person who feels he has to go for everything, so he runs for it, and there's the person who wants to experience everything and is oblivious to being destructive towards others.
Yes, that's true. I have so many different actions due to different perceptions and ways of handling events.
Well, that's what I was saying. Maybe we should... Well, what I'm saying is maybe we need to be more aware of this by developing standards.
Standards? But standards are a confinement against society.
Taken into example, though, what I'm saying is these people acting on their immediate energy, their immediate goal, without even giving any thought to anything else.
The whole point of developing the society is broadening the perception so people can see the views.
But what if people's perceptions aren't broadened? What if you don't have time? Anything could interfere with society. It could be destructive towards our society, our well-built society. What if someone out there we haven't reached yet doesn't have the time to develop all this? I mean, I have foreseen there are negative possibilities here without standards.
Maybe he's right. I mean, maybe we do need some protection, you know, from limited thought.
Well,
I always want to try to avoid standards, you know. I always try to avoid thinking about that. I mean, they're confinements. They put a damper on developing growing perception, freedom, you know. And you need freedom to create in the society, and that's what I want to develop.
But freedom won't develop. I mean, the society won't develop at all if it's stopped by destruction because of limited perception due to the non-standards controlling it.
Well, you have a point there, Bruticus. Point in check.
Gentlemen, do you think we could get everyone to broaden their perceptions? Is that your philosophy?
Yes, I'm saying we can.
But there's so many people.
Gentlemen, there's something you should know.
What is it,
Omeron? Come with me here a second.
I'll be back, Bruticus.
Alright.
Gentlemen, this man, Bruticus, he was in the old army that we led rebellion against, that you helped us so graciously. But, I mean, we're glad, but this man, he still owns the uniform, the red uniform that bears the mark of Bruticus' army that we defeated 7 years ago to have this free society. Maybe we should defend it.
But Omeron, you speak of destruction too. If we defend it, we'll have to act on our standards for our views. And we want freedom here. Not violence. Not suppression of oppression, which we fought against.
Yes, I agree, but
it's your loss.
Well, let's go back and talk to him right now. This isn't doing any good.
I might come back. Yes. We've talked about it. Omeron was just telling me about your involvement with the old army of wretches.
What? Yes, I was involved with the wretches army, but you must have it then. It was an honorable thing. We established order by standards, and it's what made us such a strong army. And society, what do you have against me anyway? It was an honorable thing, but now you've taken me in and let me be free, and I'm thankful for that. So.
I wouldn't want any violence here.
Okay, you're right. I agree. I'm against violence, too, but I still believe in standards.
But look, what is there? Why should we have to believe in standards? I mean, really, what is there to be afraid of? This society is free. We've just come out of a successful revolution.
Yes, but you nearly locked me up.
Let's do a limited judgment, and I cleared that all up, didn't I?
Yes, you did, and I'm also thankful for that. I'm thankful for my freedom, and... But now that you've taken me in, I do have a right to speak.
I'm not saying you don't have a right to speak. I mean, speak, it's just kind of hard for me to accept, you know, it's the difference in my ways. But due to broadening perception, as I say, you must adapt.
I remember in the Zeon
Monument's first speech, where he said, by putting standards on society, you can fine it. And that was one of his major words, but this is what the man stands for, Bruticus.
Yes, I know, and I don't have anything against him. I don't hate him for it. I'm just speaking.
We understand now, don't we? Listen, what is the problem? If you had been here when I was developing society, before, what I'm saying now is this: you went on a journey, and you haven't been here. Renlin has established a good, productive robots to run society's food churning wheels, and Omeron's committed to the literary movement. He's learning the writing scriptures and writing down his philosophy, which I will advise you to do too. I mean, free speech. And then we'll have a lot of literary movement and open minds everywhere, feeding on everyone else's energy. And that's such the beautiful thing that I'm trying to create here. But putting standards on that, I mean, we can't have growth, at least not at such an infinite rate.
Yes, but wasn't there a...
Journeyman?
Yes, Rendon?
Well, there is this, you know, people do get out of control. I mean, they're all little kids who do just very well damn what they please. There was one little bugger. His name must have been, Cram or, Claus, I think it was. And, he came over to the mining colony, you know, just figured he'd play, something around, dancing war around it or something, and he so I took some stones, but his mother made him turn them back, but he's still out there. There are that happens, and he wasn't punished for it, and I could tell he felt like he was getting away with it. That's what I'm saying. If this boy, just for an example, not that he's very substantial now, I mean, a poor man, but if he ever gets out of control, he could harm society or others, and yeah, we've got to be aware of that.
In government positions, yes, there are people who brought up very small
outskirts of the point, but it's never really been addressed. I think it is on some people's minds. It is a concern, though, that you will probably have to address, Journeyman.
Why does him address it? Everyone should address it.
Yes, I agree with you, but... it's just that the Journeyman's running things, you know. He's the head, he's the leader. We picked him.
Yes, I do remember that. It was a rather unanimous vote. I really give much consideration, but...
and I've picked out for help here, so I wouldn't be confining like your rule of wretched. I picked a council of advisors, Richard. I mean, you should be aware of this now. What your leader did was enslavement, and he forced everyone to follow his belief. He didn't allow for anyone else's beliefs. That's what I mean. I am doing that by picking council of advisors. If, in fact, you're the third one on the advisor.
Yes, you did inform me on that.
Well, I expect it to be active and open-minded. I will take people's views into consideration. Further direction with the society, and not to mention many others that your society didn't take, and very well it didn't survive.
Yes, well, it may not have survived on that point just because of this plain closed-mindedness and enslavement on these people, but if the standards were a strong framework in my society, and I think they should be here.
Well, maybe we should take some time to think about it. I mean, it doesn't need to be established right away. There are no immediate threats.
Yes, and that's what I think our council should be advisors. Maybe we should have a meeting on this once everybody gets situated from their recent experiences.
Yes, Richard.
Bruticus! Bruticus! My name's Bruticus. Why do you keep calling me Bretchard? Bretchard! The guy was an anchor. I hated serving under him sometimes. The name's Bruticus.
Sorry, it's just all these different names here get mixed up. I mean, I've traveled so far, different realms, parts of society, so many cultural differences in such a small
space of land. Interesting observations. But what I was going to say, Bruticus,
yes,
was that I'd like to advise you to write down, maybe learn from Omeron or what Redlin already knows about the scriptures, writing your experience with your journey, which I'm requiring for a document for you to hold all in all time through infinity.
Yes, that's a good idea. I'll get to work with that. But I do want the standards point discussed.
We'll discuss it. I think we should hold a meeting. Redlin, what do you think?
Well, I've got some work to do on my food churning wheel. How about we'll have a meeting in 2 days? Is that okay?
Yeah, that sounds good.
All right, everyone.
2 days.
That sounds fine, gentlemen.
All right.
Okay, then. Well, I'll see you in 2 days. And in the meantime, I guess I'll be thinking this over.
Nice seeing you again, gentlemen. And Bruticus, it's nice seeing you return from your journey.
Conflict in such a free environment. I thought freedom would be the element here. But I'm going to have to address standards.
Corporations with psychic vibrations, not violent sensations. You'll fight the corporations, fight the mind concentration, take a mind vacation with the alternate perceptions and fight the corporations at the psychic emanations. We'll be free to do our own thing.